how it looks like when row 5 has been finished. All double crochets on top of the previous row. Let's get started with row 6. Chain 1 and turn. Always turn every row. So now I'm facing the wrong side of my work. It says crochet 1 double crochet over the next 2 stitches. So here's the first stitch and the next. Then row 6, the pattern says skip 2 stitches, in the next stitch or in the third stitch you will make 1 double crochet, looks like this, then chain 2 and make 3 half double crochets around the double crochet that you just made, so, and then a chain 1 single crochet in the base chain from your double crochet, looks like this. The next, and this is the repeating pattern throughout the row up until the last 4 stitches. So 2 skip chain stitches, in the third you make 1 double crochet, then chain 2 and make 3 half double crochets around the double crochet. So that's number 2 and that's number 3, and here 1 single crochet, and this is how it looks like. This is to be repeated throughout the row, and we will finish off this row together. Now you skip 3 stitches, so 1 single crochet you made, 2nd and 3rd, and in the 4th you will make 1 single crochet, chain 2, and then you make 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 that you made in the previous row. So that's number 1 half double crochet, second half double crochet, and the third half double crochet. Then again skip 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3, and in the fourth you will make a single crochet, chain 2, and again 3 half double crochets around that chain 2 from the previous row, 1, 2, and number 3. This you will be repeating up until the last stitch, last 2 double crochets are left over. So this is how it looks like, 2 rows of corner to corner stitch with a half double crochet pattern. So to finish off, I just made my last 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row, and I will end off with 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet after each stitch that you have left over. So that's like this. So you start and you end with 2 double crochets. Then chain 1 and turn. Wrong side facing you. Then says make 1 double crochet over all stitches throughout the row. So here the first 2 double crochets, each you will make 1 double crochet. 1 and 2. Then 1 double crochet, the second and the third, and then you skip directly to the next corner to corner stitch, 1, 2, and 3, so you don't crochet in the single crochet you made, only on top of the half double crochets you will make 1 double crochet. So you have sections of 3, 3, 3, and you will begin with 2 double crochets and you will end off with 2 double crochets. I will show you how it looks like in a minute or in a second. Should be looking like this. Then you're correct. So you start off with 2 double crochets, then 3 double crochets, 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 double crochets throughout this row, and you will end off with 2 double crochets. So I finished this row, I will finish it off with you together. I made my last 3 double crochets on top of the 3 half double crochets previous row, and I've got 2 stitches left. So there I make each stitch 1 double crochet, 1 and 2. Chain 1 and turn your work. Now you're at the correct side of your work, facing you, And then we will start off with row 9. So this is how it should look like after row 8. All double crochets in top. We start with row 9, chain 1. I already did that one. So make one double crochet of the next two stitches. So that's the first and the second double crochet. Then skip two stitches. In the next you will make one double crochet, chain 2, and another double crochet in the same stitch, so in the third stitch. Then you will be repeat this throughout the row up until the last two stitches, and there you make two double crochets, so one double crochet in each stitch. Repeating this, skip two, in the third you will make one double crochet, two chains, and one double crochet. Then again, skip two stitches, in the third, one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet. So this is how it should look like. Two double crochets in over the first two stitches, skip two. In the third you will make one double crochet, chain two, and one double crochet, skip two stitches, one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet in the third, skip two stitches, and again one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet in the third stitch. Repeat this throughout the whole row up until the last four stitches left, and then you will make three stitches left, and then you will make in the last two stitches you will make each stitch one double crochet. So keep on repeating this and we'll finish up together. I finished the row and I said you have three stitches left, but you should have two stitches left because we start with skipping two after the two double crochets, but we end directly behind the double V-shaped stitch. So last stitches you will make one double crochet. Then chain one and turn your work, and we will start off with row 10. Row 10 is one single crochet over the next two stitches. So here and here you make each one single crochet. Then you go directly into the chain two space from the previous row, and there you make five double crochets into that first chain two space. So that's number 3, 4, and 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double crochets in the chain two space. Then you skip to the next chain two space here. Then you make one single crochet. Skip to the next chain two space, and there you make 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go directly to the next chain two space, and there you make one single crochet. So you will start with 5 double crochets in the chain two space, and you will end with a 5 double crochets in the last chain two space. So keep repeating this. So go to the next chain two space, there you make 5 double crochets. That's number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In the next chain two space you make a single crochet, and in the next chain two space again you will make 5 double crochets. 4 and number 5. Repeat this throughout this row and we'll finish row 10 off together. So I finished this row. Like I told before, you will start off with 5 double crochets in the first chain 2 space, and you end with 5 double crochets in the last chain 2 space. Then the pattern tells you to one single crochet in the last two stitches. So these two stitches are your last two stitches. So the first single crochet and the last single crochet. Chain one and turn your work. You start with one double crochet in top of the two single crochets. You skip into the third stitch. There you make two double crochet, chain one and two more double crochets in top of that stitch, and you skip to the single crochet here, and there you make one double crochet. Go to the third stitch, there you make two double crochets, one, two, a chain one and two more double crochets. Skip to the single crochet, there you make one double crochet. In the third stitch you will make two double crochet, chain one and two more double crochet. This you will be repeating throughout the row and we will end up together at the end. I finished this row with the two double crochet, chain one, two double crochet in top of the five double crochets and a double crochet on top of the single crochet. Here I'm at the end. I've got only of those two single crochet stitches left. There I make each stitch one double crochet. One and number two. Chain one and turn your work and we will start off with row 12. Row 12. One double crochet in the next two stitches. So that's here and there. So there's the first double crochet and the second double crochet. Now we start off with the repeating pattern. Chain two. Go to the chain one space, there you make one single crochet. Chain two, go to the double crochet and there you make a double crochet. So chain two, single crochet in the chain one, chain two and double crochet on top of the double crochet previous row. Chain two, single crochet in the middle, chain two, double crochet on top of the double crochet. Repeat this throughout the row up until you've got the last two stitches. Then we crochet and finish this row together. So, I finished this row. I had to attach my new yarn because my yarn ball was empty. I will make a little video of it, how I have done that, so for you to know. I chained up two. I've got those two double crochets left. There I'll make my one double crochet in top of the last two double crochets from the previous row. Row 12 is done. Now we start with row 13. Chain one and turn. Again, now you're at the correct size side of your beautiful side of your work, the good side. Now, pattern says double crochet through all stitches throughout this row. So when you see a double crochet, you will crochet on top. When you see a chain two, you will make two double crochets. In top of the single crochet, you make a double crochet, etc., etc. So first two stitches, each one double crochet. Chain two space, two double crochets. One and number two. Single crochet, one double crochet. Chain two space, two double crochets. So each stitch you'll make one double crochet throughout this row. We'll finish off this row together. So I almost finished my double crochet row. We end up together. I make my last two double crochets in the chain two space and now I make my last double crochet over the last two stitches at the end. Chain one and turn. Start with row 14. inside out, wrong side facing. Row 14, one double crochet over the next two stitches, so here and here, the first two, first and the second. You make one double crochet, one and number two. Now skip two stitches, one, two, and in the third you will make three double crochets. So that's number one, that's number two, and that's number three. Repeat this throughout until you have four stitches left at the end. So skip two, in the third you'll make three double crochets in that same stitch. Two and three. Skip two stitches, in the third you'll make three double crochets. One, two, and three. Repeat this up until the last four stitches and then we'll finish up together. So I finished this row almost. We will end up together. So every stitch, every third stitch have three double crochets in them. End up together. Like I said, you will have four stitches left over. You skip the next two stitches and in the third and in the fourth you'll make each one double crochet. Chain one and turn your work. Good side facing you. Row 15. Chain one and one double crochet in the next stitch. Next two stitches. Sorry, row, So that's number one and there's number two. Now you make one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet in the middle of this three double crochets in the stitch. So actually you skip one and in the next you make one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet, and then between those three and three double crochets here in this hole you will make one double crochet. Now we start repeating the pattern. Skip one stitch, in the middle of the three you make one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet, and in between those sets of three double crochets you make one double crochet. Show you how it looks like this. So this is your repeating pattern throughout the row, like this. One double crochet between the two times three double crochets, and then in the middle of the double crochet, double crochet, chain two, and double crochet. Repeat this throughout the row, and I will see you at the last two double crochets at the end of this row. I'll finish off together, and we start row number 16. I finish this row. It's a double crochet, chain two, double crochet in the middle of these three, so in the second, and a double crochet between them. Like the pattern says, you have two stitches, two double crochets left. In those you'll make each one double crochet. So here it is. Chain one and turn your work. Turn my work. Now you make two double crochets, one in each stitch and the beginning of the row. So on top of those two double crochets you make each one double crochet. In the chain two space you make two double crochet, one and number two. On top of the double crochet you make one double crochet. In the chain two space you make two double crochet. So you will make two double crochets in the chain two space and one double crochet on top of the single double crochet, so it's a lone standing double crochet. Repeat this throughout the row. We finish off this row together and then we will start off with row number 17. This is how it looks like. So I put two double crochets in the chain two space from the previous row and one double crochet on top of the double crochet you made from the previous row. Repeat that and we'll end this row off together. I finished this row with the double crochet on top of the double crochet and the two double crochets in a chain two space. We end up this row together. Got two double crochets left, and each one of them I make one double crochet. One and number two. This is your work so far. We have started up here. This piece you have done. Row number, let's see, 16 you have done here. Then we will start off with row number 17. There's a cross stitches. I try to explain it on paper, but sometimes it's easier to make it on a film. So we'll start off with row 17 row 16 in a couple of seconds, and then we will be making the cross stitch, and then we will go with double crocheting around. So yeah, row 17, sorry. Cross stitch is made out of treble crochet. You can make it in multiple ways. I've explained here the most easiest way on paper is just to skip two stitches, and in the third you will make your treble crochet, chain one, and you will go make a treble crochet in the first skipped stitch, and so on and so on. Well, I will show you multiple ways how to do this cross stitch and the way that I prefer, but it's really hard to put that one on paper. So please stay tuned. In the next video, we will start off with row 17, the cross stitch.